Usually in an exams, especially the basic exams, we have what they call the section A and the section D. Usually the section A is the objective part. How come correct? Yes, and the section D is the written part. If you care to know, you have to answer both sections to pass. You can't just do section A and ignore section B. Neither could you do it the other way around. So the exam is both parts. This morning, Jesus has given you and I the two sections of the spiritual exams. One, the section A is hearing the word of God, which everybody can do. No, today I'm preaching, you are listening to me. Very easy. Everybody can listen to it, everybody can hear it. But the section B, which is difficult, is the practicing part, theory and practice. And that is the difficult part. And usually when it comes there, some of us can find it very difficult. Because obeying what you have heard is the matter. So he puts to us this morning the story of two people. They built equally, they had the same circumstance, but when the storms of life came, they knew the difference between the one who studied both section A and section B. The one who hears God's word and the one who practices it, the difference was clear. And in the first video, we have been given one of such storms. It happens in marriages. A man, a young man, a young lady, they marry, and then they can give birth to children. Abraham and his wife, a very typical crisis in marriages. So what do we do? So the wife said, okay, you sleep with my maid and make children out of her for me. The mistake she did, I say now, is that Sarah wanted to make provision for God. Because we are told that it was 10 years. You know, they had been in the promised land for 10 years, which means that God's promise to Abraham that he would give him a child had taken 10 years. Nothing had happened. So Sarah, like human being, said, okay, if God is delaying, let me make my own suggestion. Go and sleep with my maid. When we decide to make suggestions for God, to make provisions for God, it brings more crisis. Anyway, thanks to God, the boy who was born to her, God found a way of bringing the families together, Ishmael's family and then Isaac's family. It will take some 40 years more for God's promise in Abraham's life to come to pass. But be patient with the Lord. Wait upon the Lord. Don't make suggestions for God. Don't make provisions for God. And if God sees that, he calls it faithfulness, he'll be faithful to you also. We pray for all those who are having such storms in their marriages, especially the issues of children, that God should make a way when there seems to be no way. Amen.